former sports talk worldwide with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, this is some wild news, right? Heavyweight news. It's good news. It's something that, you know, hey, a lot of people that are into boxing, heavyweight boxing, for let's say the last 4 or 5 years. Then you have major players. You have the champions and you have major players. You know, the major players, the Joseph Parkers, you know, well, Herkovich is not one yet. You know, like, but a Joe Joyce is one now, a major player. A Dillian White is a major player. Povetkin is a major player. Luis Ortiz is a major player. You know, guys that were probably not champions, right? But we know damn well they good. You know what I'm saying? Those kind of guys, your major players. I'm forgetting them all. I don't know every damn thing, obviously, right? But, you know, major players. So we got two major players, right, I'm about to talk about. One is Dillian White, right? Dillian White is a major player. Only got two losses. Both losses, he was knocked the hell out, right? But Dillian White's a bad dude. You know, if Dillian White shows up in the house, it's going to be a fight, right? It's going to be a fight with Dillian White. It is what it is. I don't like the guy, right, because of a lot of stuff that he did in the past, right, and because of perception, right? A few things that people just won't get in their head no matter how many times you tell them it, and it, no matter how many times that they realize it's the truth, but they ignore it, right? And so, like, for example, wanting to, always talking about wanting to fight Deontay Wilder, and the WBC, which we don't like, right, corrupt, but they were telling him, hey, you know, you got to fight Luis Ortiz, he's the mandatory, and then Dillian White didn't want to do that. Then even Deontay Wilder said, hey, dude, you want me? I promise you. You fight Ortiz, you get me. And it didn't happen then either. But Dillian White got knocked out by Povetkin while leading the fight. We can't forget that, people. Dillian White was leading the fight and doing it, had a pretty damn good performance until that left shot came in. Right? Let's give him that. So, you know, but he was supposed to have the rematch. Povetkin got COVID, and COVID, it doesn't work asymptomatic with everybody. You know, we keep thinking it's asymptomatic because a few of these athletes have gotten it, and then, you know, they're okay. Well, not in all cases. So he's having some residue from this COVID, and so they have to push the date back with, matter of fact, indefinitely. We don't even know when the next date would be for Dillian White and Povetkin to have that rematch. So Dillian White's like, man, shoot. Yesterday he had a four-man list. And I just don't take the four-man list seriously. I read the four-man list, and I'm going to tell you how cynical I am over the years of covering this stuff, and I just understand what's going on. He mentioned Deontay Wilder, Andy Ruiz Jr., Luis the Real King Kong Ortiz, and then they mentioned Chisora, right? So for me, it was like, oh, that's the Chisora trilogy, because the mother dudes he ain't messing with. That's how I looked at it. I mean, I ain't even talking about that because it's Chisora, and I'm about to hear this going to be Chisora in a couple of weeks. These other names just out there, just so it won't look bad. But we fighting Chisora. That's what it sounded like to me. But now I got a little different news from you. It's a day later, and now I'm going to say something about this. He says he wants Luis the Real King Kong Ortiz in February, and then he'll get to Povetkin in April. That's big news, period. And it's a quote in the article that I read from Dillian White saying, hey, let me get Ortiz in February. That's good enough for me, right? Because it's coming out of his mouth. Now, you're talking Luis the Real King Kong Ortiz, right? Some people call him the boogeyman of the division. You can call him that. I call him the candy man because you say his name 3 times, he's coming, but you don't got to say it 3 times. Bottom line is this. Say, now that he's quoted saying your boy, he wants Luis Ortiz in February, he probably got him. And the only way it ain't going to happen, even said in the articles, if Ortiz is already locked down to fight Andy Ruiz Jr., which would be a bit lucrative, but either one of the fights, right? If Luis the Real King Ortiz is going to fight Andy Ruiz Jr., okay, that's a good fight too. But Luis the Real King Kong Ortiz versus Dillian White is a huge fight, and on either side of the pond. We can act like, oh, in America, it ain't going to be this and it ain't going to be that. BS. In America, yeah, we racist. 75 million voted for an obvious criminal because of white supremacy. It is what it is. We'll talk around that. 75 million, they've seen them do all these crimes and they're still down with it. Bottom line. And it's the way that is in boxing too. But at the end of the day, it's two black dudes fighting and there ain't no horse in there. They ain't got no horse in the race. So they don't give a damn. We're going to watch some heavyweight fighting, two dudes beat each other up. It ain't nobody we're going to root against or for. So that fight is going to be big. Two heavyweight dudes that's close to the top. They're going to watch that, right? And England is huge anyway. Everybody in England knows who Lewis the real King Kong Ortiz is. They play like they don't. It's the guy that they don't want Joshua to fight. It's the guy that they don't want Tyson Fury to fight. It's the guy that they don't want Dillian White to fight. That guy. They know who that is. The guy that they call old, but every other person that's just old that people are fighting. Pulev is old. Same age as Ortiz. Just 1 year younger. Povetkin's the exact same age as Ortiz. And all these other old dudes. Takum is the exact same age as Ortiz. You know what I'm saying? But we can fight them. But this old dude, now he's just old. So at the end of the day, Dillian White versus Ortiz is a big fight no matter where you're at on the globe. Bottom line. It's a big fight with two heavyweights that we know are pretty awesome, even though they had a couple of losses here or there. It's three losses between them, but we still know that Dillian White is awesome, and so is Lewis the Real King Kong Ortiz. Matter of fact, he's one of my Negro League fighters. He needs a high-profile fight, but either one of them. Andy Ruiz Jr. is also high-profile. But I would be honest with you, because of the history these two got, I would rather Dillian White to fight Lewis the Real King Kong Ortiz. He said he wants him in February. Watch out, y'all, because he probably gonna get it. Doma Sports Talk Worldwide. And we up out of here, y'all.